So, I don't want to play No Man's Sky. I don't want to play No Man's Sky next. I heard the story about General Lokar. And I heard, you know, hashtag free General Lokar. It affected me. It affected me in a certain way. Without General Lokar, and without what he was attempting to do to the No Man's Sky community, then we don't have a need for all these defense forces, and we don't have a need for all these protective individuals that are looking to protect their hubs. You know, without General Lokar, that's not possible. So do I get into a little role play? Huh? Do I get into a little role play and take his place? Are the mercenaries of the law firm going to take the place of General Lokar? Exactly, Wi-Fi. Who wants a utopia? It's a dangerous universe out there. It's a dangerous universe. So I'm kind of deciding what I want to do. Because Ishanska said the whole Lokar situation is ridiculous. It is ridiculous. It is ridiculous. And that's what's making me have these thoughts, you know? Without General Lokar, I mean, what is there to protect? Should I put together a band of mercenaries that go throughout the galaxy and cause a lot of problems for people, force people to create defense forces? I think General Lokar, his absence leaves a hole in the NMS community. We needed that. We needed that type of roleplay. And they're trying to shut him down and quiet him up. Yeah, Shanska, I feel the exact same way. They're going to regret it because all that they did was bring a lot of attention to what he was trying to do. And then there's people like me. I don't agree with what happened. I don't agree with what they're doing. So there might be people like myself that take a piece of the Lokar pie. And then there's going to be others, and there's going to be others, and there's going to be others. And now you really are going to need your defense force. Well, they effectively quieted him down. He's shut down his, what, Twitter, YouTube, all of his stuff is gone. So there were real life consequences to trying to role play in No Man's Sky? I don't agree with that. I don't agree with that. I'm pissed about it. Sean Sky's pissed about it. Cobra's pissed about it. I don't think anybody except for those individuals that went after him are happy about it. In the Euclid Galaxy, on a launch day, say, trying to decide on how I'm going to accept the fate of General Lokar. Do I put together a band of mercenaries, the Lawless? Does the mercenary band called the Lawless, do we avenge Lokar? Do we avenge Lokar? Very good question. I'm still deciding this. We're gonna do our little prerequisite stuff, and we are going to find our glyphs. And then when I find all of my glyphs, I am going to portal my way back to the farming collective. I'll probably stay there and make about 2 or 3 billion. I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna find the biggest, baddest fucking starship I can find. And by that time, I think I will have made my decision on how I want to play No Man's Sky next. Right? This whole Lokar situation will probably settle. We'll figure out kind of where that's going and how it's gonna affect the community. And if I continue to be disgruntled, because right now I'm disgruntled. If I continue to be disgruntled, I promise you, I will take his place. I'm saying this on a live stream. Like, clip it, send it to somebody. If I'm not happy with how that situation turns out, I will take his place. And don't you deny for one moment that I don't have resources at my fingertips, that I don't have power enough to be as or more effective than he would have been in his attempt to do what he was trying to do. So, that's kind of where we are with that. bigger. This is all role playing, right, guys? This is all role playing, having fun within the bounds of No Man's Sky. It went outside of role playing. It went outside of No Man's Sky. It went outside of the bounds of having fun in the game, you know? And it moved into his real life. That's money, man. YouTube is money. So come after me. Come on after Law. Come after Law. Let's see how that works out. Shouts, guys, said, "Damn, Law, you pissed." Yeah, man. I'm a little beside myself about it. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little beside myself about it because what it does is it pretty much stifles expression. It stifles role playing. It stifles what the game is about. I mean, he said, "I'm not sure about all the dirty details, but I know it was unnecessarily shut down, and that's not on." Yeah, pretty much. That's the gist of it. There's, you know. Wi-Fi said I need to get up to date on the low car. Let's update Wi-Fi really quick. Let's update Wi-Fi on this whole situation. As I do that, I'm just going to kind of run around, collect some resources, and continue on my little grind here, right? So, Wi-Fi. General Lokar is an individual that when we all caught wind of No Man's Sky Next in the multiplayer, and if you want to be that guy, right? So if you want to be that guy, then you can prey on other players. You can pretty much cause war with hubs because you'll be able to go in, effectively shoot down people. We don't know the extent of the damage you can cause. We don't know if you can cause damage to someone's base. We don't know if you can, you know, do any type of damage like that. That remains to be seen. But General Lokar, what he said he was going to do was he was about to cause chaos in the galaxy. He was about to cause chaos in the galaxy, right? And he was like, "We're going to start war. There's going to be war, and I'm going to bring it to you." This is what Lokar is saying. We're going to start war, and I'm bringing it to your doorstep. And what happened as a result of him saying that, as a result of him putting himself out there like that, people decided that they wanted to join his cause, right? So people wanted to join Lokar in order to cause chaos, in order to increase the role-playing experience, right? Once his movement started to build and everybody started to catch wind of what he was trying to do, you know, people in the No Man's Sky community got ass hurt because it was like, "Nah, I work so high for all of this. I don't want nobody messing it up, and I just want to explore, and I just, you know, and Lokar is, you know, putting that in jeopardy, and blah, 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 blah," right? And so, in response to General Lokar saying that he was going to do this, saying that he was about to make war, right? But it turns out that whatever they were hanging over his head, whatever they threatened him with was real life. Whatever they were threatening him with was real life stuff. Because he ended up shutting down his Twitter account, shutting down his YouTube. He's no longer on social media. Nobody can even find the guy. So what the hell happened? You know? And it's all because he wanted to have his kind of fun in No Man's Sky. His type of fun in No Man's Sky was different than what other people's type of fun was. And so, as a result, it went from in-game to real life. Like, it bled out into real life. So now he's gone. And there are multiple people not happy about it. Cobra just made a video about it. He's not happy. I'm going to post my first probably 10 or 15 minutes of this stream and let people know I'm not happy about it. And as a result of my disgruntled nature, I'm thinking about I could possibly take his place. Maybe not as effectively as he would have, but maybe even more effectively. So he said, "I would have the same idea as you." Yeah, I'm telling you, man, things are different. Wi-Fi said, "Yeah, I'm ass hurt now. I'll do it. I'll join. Hell yeah." So you heard it here first, ladies and gentlemen. Law of Evolution and Wyatt Ward, also known as Wi-Fi, are the first two members of the Lawless, because nobody else seems to want to fill those shoes. Nobody wants to be that guy. And I didn't either. I mean, up until this point, I was all like, "Oh man, there's gonna be new planets and new exotic worlds, and I could go around with my friends and walk around on planets." But then we get this news, and now all of a sudden, I'm like, or walk around with my friends and explore planets and shoot the shit out of people, start wars and cause problems because I don't agree with how that situation went down. So you never know. Things might change, you know? A week from now I might be like, you know what? I was just angry and, you know, everything's okay. I don't want to be a mercenary anymore. I don't want to be the bad guy. Okay? Who knows? Maybe next week I'll be even more upset about it and I announce to the No Man's Sky community that I will be doing this. You never know. You never know. Sora said, I'm really more worried we are saying and doing things as a community we won't recover from, and we have no clue how comprehensive PvP will be. That's true. That's true. What if, like, what if people are doing all this and coming at Lokar in this way, and he and Nex comes out and he doesn't even have an effective way to cause war, right? Like, what if everybody's doing all this, just like Sword is saying, we're saying and doing all this stuff as a community, and then stuff isn't even possible the way that we thought it was possible, and you won't be able to come back from that. Now you're just a dick, you know, and war wasn't even possible. So we'll see.